The task left was taking up few examples and demonstrating. So if you see this carefully, this example one, it's a 2-bit up counter. In this 2-bit up counter, let us straight talk the code instead of going to this theory. Let us talk about this code. In this code, if you see carefully, what we have here, this one, you have this parameter, and you have here one more parameter. And this first one is n, it is. The second one is a down here, this one, the down. So now this style, you know, this style here is a 2001 language standardization. So you, by this time, everyone, those who are attending from the beginning, they must be aware what is meant by 2001 court declaration style and 1995 court declaration style. One must be aware, because those who are attending from the beginning, they must be knowing about this. And those who are not familiar, they can put a message on the WhatsApp. I will reply there. So here, this module counter having, let us say this is our black box or block diagram. So what is that it is having? One is a input, this clock signal. This clock signal is an input. And the other is a reset M. This is another signal that we have, a reset M. And one more signal we have, this is enable. So this is enable. And we have this one output. This output variable is out. So we have one output variable that is out. This is our black box. So some books and most of the industry people call it as a black box. Some books will call it as a block diagram. So now what is the point here that we have to understand? This block diagram having some primary inputs and some primary outputs. So you have here, these are primary inputs. These are your primary inputs. And this one is your primary output. Now, if you see the description here, the code description, this always is a keyword. Always is a keyword, and it is called procedural construct. If you have attended earlier classes, we have told that one is a procedural construct. It's the E, yes, it's E. So that is a procedural construct. How many procedural constructs we have? If you remember someone there, we have two procedural constructs. One is always, the other is initial. The other is initial. So this one here in this code, what we are addressing, or how we are developing the code, I will brief this one. Actually, this piece of code belongs to unit 4, that is behavioral level modeling. Since we are understanding how parameters are used, for that reason, this code I will explain at this point. More elaboratively, such always usage, such initial usage, we will see in subsequent classes. How we are using always, why it is used, why initial is used, where it is used, all such explanations will be given in subsequent classes. But for today, just to understand this parameter usage, I will explain this code functionality. Always is a procedural construct that we have to understand. It is synthesizable, it is very much synthesizable. Since the moment when I say synthesizable, everyone must able to understand what I mean there, because several times I demonstrated what is meaning of synthesizable. Meaning any language construct, construct means any keyword, language keyword. That is technically we call construct. Any language construct is synthesizable, meaning if it undergoes a EDA tool, that is electronic design automation tool, it will produce for us gates information, gate level netlist gates. So if that is happening, if that keyword is giving us, undergoing this EDA tool and giving us a EDA gates, it means what? That keyword is a synthesizer. So now this always here keyword is a synthesizer. Always at this, you see at here, at usage, this at is a event control operator. What it is a event control operator. You have seen in earlier test bench demonstration, the hash, you have seen hash. What it was hash? Hash, if you remember, it is a delay control operator. It is a delay control operator. What is this event control operator? It is this at. This at is a event control operator. So now this always at, within the parenthesis is a syntax. Pause at block, this pause at is a keyword. We have this pause at here, this pause at is a keyword. We have the counterpart of that is a neg edge. You have to learn at this stage also. You can learn, you instead waiting till that fourth unit. Neg edge is a counterpart of this pause edge. And the neg edge and pause edge both are keywords in the language. What they do like this. We have this, you know, in a digital circuits, we have the clock. Flip flops will work at the edges. They are edge sensitive. Maybe this positive edge or maybe this negative edge. This is called negative edge. Flip-flop may work as per the requirement, as per the design. It may work at a positive edge. It may be a positive edge sensitive, or it may be a negative edge sensitive. That behavior we are putting here, that behavior always at pause edge CLK. CLK is this identity. Always at pause edge clock, this begin. If you see this begin, and somewhere we have here end. So this begin and end, these are keywords. If you have multiple statements inside always, this is always. In this always, if you have multiple statements the way you see here, then we put here this begin and end. If you have only one statement, for example, say always at pause edge, this pause edge CLK clock, and I am writing here something like I am assigning to A something. Here only one statement, this is the only statement you have. So in that case, you don't need this begin and this end. If you are putting also, no problem, but it's not required. Satish, are you there?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So this begin and end, these are required only when if you have such multiple statements. If you have only one statement, the way here shown here this way, then you don't need to have this begin and end. You have to remember that one. Now coming to this one here, what we are doing here, let me clear this. You got this, why we are using this begin. After that, if reset, this is a negation operator. This one is a logical negation. We have operators, we had to study. Operators will come in data flow level modeling. We haven't yet started, so that will come. But at this point, I have to make the things clear why, how this code is functioning. So this is a negation operator. This one, exclamation mark, is a negation. So reset n, meaning what? If you have a zero, if you have zero, so you have your design, when zero comes here, that is your reset n, then this entire system is set to some known value. Suppose, for example, in this case, the known value we are giving as a zero. So meaning here, this out signal is set to what? Zero, when this reset is zero. That is the meaning here. If negation of reset, meaning you are negating this zero. If you are negating this zero, if you are negating this zero like this, this is exclamation, meaning you are negating the zero means it is one. It is one means it, one means in the language it is true. Is it true? If true, then perform this operation. Else come to this one. If you observe carefully here, this begin and this end not required. Why? Because here only we have one statement, that is out. If there would have been multiple statements with after this if statement, this if within the if there would have been other than this out multiple statements, then this begin and end is required. Otherwise, if negation reset n out is less than or equal to, this is assignment operator, don't think this is a less than or equal to, this is a non-blocking. We have blocking assignment and non-blocking assignments. So this is everything you will learn in that behavior level modeling. At this point, you don't need to worry. Blocking and non-blocking. This is a blocking assignment operator. So this is there is another. This is I don't want to confuse here. You just have to understand there are two sort of assignments. One is a blocking assignment operator. The other one is a non-blocking assignment operator. This is a non-blocking. Non-blocking assignment operator, what it does is, if multiple A equal to B, and then Z equal to A, and then Y equal to Z, if we have equal, I am using. So unless this is not, this should be executed first, then only this value will be, this statement will be executed. Meaning this is blocking. This is blocking the execution of this second one. That's why this equal assignment operator is called blocking assignment operator. Equal is called blocking assignment operator. Why blocking assignment operator? If we have 1, 2, 3 such statements are there, so this should be executed first. This B needs to be assigned to A. Then only the second statement will be executed by the compiler. Then, once the second is executed, then only this will be executed. So meaning what? This assignment operator is blocking the execution of the second one. We can parallelly do this one. How? If you put everywhere this less than or equal to, parallelly it will be. Like the old value of B will be assigned to A. The old value, not the current, this the updated, not the updated one, the old value of A will be updated here to the Z, and the old value of Z will be updated to the Y with the help of this less than or equal to. This less than or equal to is not going to block the assignment parallelly. 1, 2, 3, all three are executed parallelly. That's why this is called non-blocking assignment operator. So let me clear this here once. Okay, so guys, here I was talking about this one. Out is zero when this is zero. Else begin, if enable, meaning if enable is one. If enable is one, then we are coming and checking another condition. If down meaning down, simply down if you write, is down one, that is the meaning. If you put explicitly like this, if down equal to one, this is assignment operator. So equality checking is double equal everywhere. If enable double equal, that is equality checking. So if enable equal to 1, nothing but this way also you can write. If enable, both are same. If enable, that is this true, then you come here and check. If is this true, then you perform this operation, down. If down is enabled high, then we are performing down, I mean count down. Else, count up, up counter, it is like a up counter. So that is what here happening in this case. This is else begin, this begin started here, this begin. After this begin, we have this if, and this inside this if, we have this if else together, this is one. And this relate, this for if, this for this if, this is the else. This else is related to this if. And this for this if, this is the else. If this is zero, I mean this is zero, if this happens to be zero, meaning this portion will not be treated by the compiler. This is not going to be treated by the compiler when this enable is zero. Else, out is out. Whatever the value is there, that will be there. So that is how this the black box earlier I drawn here. One is having a clock. The other is a reset, negative reset. That's why we are putting a N, negative reset, meaning for low, it is going to be resetted. And the what more here? Enable. This enable is there. If enable is high, then only it is going to perform like a counter. That's how the hardware is working here. So hopefully this is clear to everyone there. I have made it clear this why this always is, why this this at symbol is, this event control operator always is a procedural construct. Putting this parenthesis is a part of the syntax. Posit is the keyword. Clock is this identifier. Posit is the keyword because we digital circuits, especially our flip-flops, are edge sensitive. In order to model them, we have to have a keyword. For that, we have the counterpart also, negate also we have. If you want to design a behavior for negate, then you can use this keyword. And then you come here, you check this is the logical negation operator, this exclamation. If reset and begin, you set the out here, this out variable, you are setting it to zero. And then else you check this enable is high. If high, then whether to perform up count or down count that you do here. If this enable is not enabled, that is zero, then out is held previously, whatever the out is, that only held here. So that is the brief description. Can anyone point what is the mistake in this? Can someone point here? What is the mistake? There is some mistake in this. I will give the clue where the mistake is. In this black box and the para, this the port list here that we have. I think there is a mistake. Can someone there? Is there a mistake or not? That's the point. I'm not telling there is a mistake. Is there a mistake or not? Is everything is okay, Satish?
Yes, sir. Everything understand?
Okay. Do you sense any sort of mistake in the this port here and the black box one-to-one comparison?
Yes, sir. As per my knowledge, because I am not expert, sir.
So. No. It's not about the expert. Here, see, we have. Okay, you can mute now. The point that I am trying to make here is everyone there. Why I questioned that way? I will tell you. I will tell everyone. So the point. Jack. Yeah.
Suresh.
Yeah, Suresh.
Like you are telling there is some mistake or what? Correct, right? Because here no. Input and output, inputs all are in a wire type, right? But output is in the res type. What is this? Is not a mistake.
That's not a mistake. That's a good observation. Yeah. That Suresh, that's a good observation, but that's not a mistake.
Sir, that the it is okay, a negative. A
no. I will make the thing here clear. Kindly, everybody mute.
Yes.
The point I'm trying to make here is. if you see here, this black box, I spoke about the clock. Okay, clock is there according to the description of this code. Here is the input. So in the black box also we have the clock. That is okay, absolutely fine. And coming to the reset n, that is also absolutely fine. Absolutely fine. Black box and the description. Now coming to the enable, that is also there. We have shown in the black box, that is enable. And in a port declaration also enable is there. That is also absolutely fine. Now coming to this output port here, we have out, and in the black box also we have, here in the port declaration also we have absolutely fine. Now if you go to the description, logic description, this area is called port types and port declaration area. So port list declaration and port type according to 2001 standard, the style followed here is the 2001. But this is a logic. Here we are describing the logic. In this logic, if you observe here, we have used this input, okay, no problem. We have used this reset, okay, no problem. So this is used, clock is used, reset is used, and this enable also is used, no issues with that. Accordingly, now it is going to perform maybe a down counter or up counter. The point here that I am trying to make is, if you see this down here, down is not a port here. If you observe carefully, down, if you see this black box, in the entire black box, we don't have anywhere port. Down is not a port here. And in the port list also, it is not listed like a port here. Neither it's the input nor the output. It is not listed. And what is that doing here? Here, if you focus this one, if you focus this one, it is some constant. It is why parameters are basically used. Basically, parameters are used for this constants. So, this constants. So, other than the, acting like a constant, they are also like for parameterized for generic module description. Also, they are helping us, these parameters. In two senses, they are helping. Now, the point that I'm trying to make here is, how is that this is going to play when this is not a port? So, will that be synthesizable? If synthesized, then what sort of impact this down is going to have here on the hardware? So, when it is not a port, when it is a constant, so will that make any difference to our hardware? That's the point that I am asking you people to think. You keep thinking. If my question is clear, let me one more time try my question. What I'm trying to make my question is, basically we see the black box or block diagram. In the block diagram, we try to identify our primary inputs and our primary outputs. And based on our primary inputs list, We list out all ports here in the declaration area, and based on our primary outputs, we list them, identifies here, and accordingly the type declaration also we do. So thereafter, accordingly, based on this input and output, we describe our logic here, this functionality. Logic means the functionality of this hardware. Functionality of this hardware, we describe the logic description or a behavior description of this black box will go here. So while it has gone here, that is absolutely fine. If when we talk about when positive edge has come, when this is reset is set to zero, then make output zero. Else, then you come here. This is outer if. This outer if else is here. This is inner if. That is here. Else is here. So when down is zero, then this is performing acting like a down counter. When down is one, then it is acting like an up counter. So with this down control, you are not having. Do you have down control here at the input side? That is the point number one to observe as a hardware design engineer. Point number one that we have to observe is, if you are giving this this hardware, this hardware, this entire hardware to a customer. So in which sense you will address him? So this hardware will work like a up counter, a down counter, whether that guy and a customer, whether is she or he having control over this hardware, can they make it work like a up counter whenever they want? Can they make it work for a down counter whenever they want? So such observation skills are required. That's the point that I'm trying to make at this point. Now I don't want any answers from you guys. Tomorrow this will be the first question to everyone present today. So what ultimate this hardware will be? Will it be a down counter? Can it work? Like a question is like this. Can it work whenever I want like a up counter? Whenever I want like a down counter? Can I make it work? Hardware I'm talking about, not at this behavioral level, not at the code level. Once you fabricate this, out of this you generate the hardware, right? You perform something called synthesize, right? Here I said several times, this code is given to some software called synthesizer. So this, once you perform this synthesis, what it is going to give you? The hardware netlist. Once you obtain out of this code the hardware, that is netlist, now my question to you everyone there is, what is this hardware? Can I make it workable for up and down, or will it be fixed for down, or will it be fixed for up? That's what the question. Hope my question is I have conveyed you people. Right now I don't want any answer, but you think. Other than that, the entire code description what I gave so far, that is how this is working. Whether is that clear? The description part is that clear. Question part is secondary. The question has come later on, but earlier I gave the description entire starting from the module to here till out. I gave the explanation. Whether that explanation is clear to everyone? Can someone, Satish? Can you unmute?
Yes, sir. Okay. Explanation is clear, sir.
Okay,
but
okay.
I have one doubt.
Doubt you ask.
Sir, can we put enable is equal to one in always block?
Can we put enable for that? Can straight away you want to put one here?
Yes, sir. Enable is equal to one in always block. If I write the following, whatever we have down counter will be executed when enable is equal to one.
Then it means what you are hard coding. You are what you are doing hard coding. Permanently you are fixing as a one. Then you don't have as an input here. This is no more port. This port is tied to one always. Are you getting the point?
Yes, sir.
So but we want to give the control to the customer. Your ultimate chip designer aim is to the IC designer aim is to produce the hardware chip, right? A tangible IC, right? Integrated circuit, right? Hello.
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
So that IC designer wants to give control to the customer, that whenever the customer wants enable one, then only this hardware should work like a counter. If customer setting to zero, then this hardware should not work like a counter.
Okay, sir.
So in that case, if you are fixing it to one, it means you are hard coding it. You are hard coding, meaning always you are tying it to one. So there is no point of input. There is no point of having this control here. So always it will work like a counter only, without irrespective of there is no meaning left now. This port control is not there. Port control is not there by the customer.
Okay, sir. Understood.
Okay. Other than that, are there any queries by others? Okay, if no queries, let us quickly go to. But remember my question. If you give this entire code to the synthesizer, so my question is again, is it going to work like whenever I wish, like up, whenever I wish, like down? Is there any such control by the customer, by the end user? Or no, it is like up only, or no, it is like a down only. If you say down only, then you have to justify why. If you say it's up only, then you have to justify why up only. If you agree to this up and down, yeah, I can make it sometimes workable up, and sometimes workable like down that hardware. Once you produce the hardware, I'm talking about the separating the line here, demarcation line here. Yeah, I'm not talking about the code. I'm talking about after you give it to the synthesizer here, this synthesizer tool, this code, this hardware, whatever generated. So this code in this three category where it fits. That is my question. So let us move to the continuation, our explanation. So our main task is, okay, you guys now understood this entire code is actually, this is, if you observe carefully here, this one. The point to observe is two things you have to observe. One is this keyword out. In combination with this out, we also have used reg here. You remember this? Actually, this out belongs to which data type? Net data type. And this reg belongs to which data type? Variable data type. According to 1995 standards, what was the name for this variable data type? Register. This was the name, register data type. To this register data type, it belongs, this reg. But if you see in the code, out and reg, both are declared together here for this out identifier. Why it is so? Answer is, whenever you have used here procedural construct, remember how many procedural constructs are there? Two. One is always, the other is initial. Whenever you use a procedural construct, inside that, if there is a left-hand side, anything that is there, anything left-hand side, that must belong to reg data type. Remember, that must belong to variable data type. In fact, not reg. Remember, that must belong to which data type? Variable. If imagine for a while this reg is not there here, then what happens? This is not going to work in the synthesizer tool, that EDA tool, you know, electronic design automation tool. That is not going to give you the hardware. It is going to throw error. The reason is the compiler is so designed that if it is procedural construct, you are using always or initial. Being in this procedural construct, whatever the left-hand side is there, whatever left-hand side, target side, instead left-hand side, you say target side. This target side variables, identifiers, they must belong to variable data type. That's why here this out is along with that. This is also applied onto this out. Now what is applied? Since it is a port type is out, this is applied anyway. And since this out is getting assignments being in a this procedural construct, this out is getting assignments. It is being assigned here. So target side, it has come on the left hand side, that is target side. So that's why this reg declaration is compulsory. That is the syntax that demands, the compiler demands that. So that is what about this portion also. I just forgot to clear about this when Suresh was talking about this reg something. At that time, I recollected to emphasize even this point, why we are using output and reg together here. So hope this is clear. Remember from now on, if you're writing any code, always inside, if there is a target side, ensure that the target side belongs to which data type? Variable data type. Within the variable data type, there are subtypes. You have seen an earlier slide. So there is a reg, there is an integer, There is a real time, there is a time, total five subtypes are there. To these five types, anything it can belong, but it must belong to variable data type. So in this case, we are using it as a reg. So now let us move on to this. Using this two bit, now what we are going to do, this is the magic that we are going to do. In this magic, we have used the module and the design top here. Use design top. This is another module. And you are using input clock and the reset same and this enable same. And this, if you see, this is also same. I mean, two bits only. And there is nothing magic here. Simply we are instantiating this counter. Where is this counter you found? Here. This counter, this module name. This counter you are instantiating. Remember instantiating several times I said instantiation. So instantiated here. Where it is instantiated? In this module. This module is instantiated. This is the instantiated. And you know this one, why we are writing this one. This is several times in the previous sessions we have seen. We override parameter using this approach. Hash, you use the hash and parentheses. And then dot, this is called, what is that? Anyone remember this? We have a positional mapping and named mapping we have seen. Do you remember? Port mapping, port binding, port association. Positional and named. So this is named. And we are not mapping the port. We are overriding the parameter. So how we are overriding? Using named. So what is the name here? Dot n. This n is belongs to this counter. You don't see this n here in this current anywhere here. This n, if you see this dot n immediately, that is here somewhere here. This one. This n. So, and you want to update that n. This is how you update with whatever the value that you feel like. This could be a 4, this could be 8, anything that is like m. And then what is this? This one. Instantiation name, that is the instantiation name, that is must remember. In a primitives language primitives it is not must, but here it is must. This instantiation name, it is user defined, anything that you can put. And then this everywhere you see the dot clock, dot reset n, dot enable, all these are the port names that we have used in this counter. Dot n, and this clock is here somewhere you use here, and this reset here somewhere you use, and this enable you have used somewhere here. Remember within the parentheses those identifiers are actually local to the current module, local to this current module. And immediately after dot you see the dot here. After that dot, whatever the identifier you see, it is actually not a local to this. It is the identifier here, what the module that you have instantiated, in that these identifiers are used. And your intention is to bind this variable with the variable that is there in the top module, this one. So that's how you have binded here. Now you may ask, what is the magic that we did here? In this example, there is no magic that we did. Because, why? Because here it is after all, 2 we are passing, and the 2 very 2 is already there here. So meaning we are ending up with again 2-bit counter only. So there is no magic. So now if you see here, this is the same again, the counter only, counter example. If you see here, then you see you have noticed here, we have used 4. And you have used this down now. You see this dot down. This dot down is not here anywhere. Then where? I was telling immediately followed by this dot. Whatever that comes, that belongs to instantiated module. And you are binding it to some value here. You bind it with some value that is 1. If you see your this child module, our leaf module, you see leaf module, this down is actually 0. Now with the help of that, what you are doing, you are overriding instead 0 with the 1. This one here, this one, you are overriding. So meaning this entire one, you did not actually write any counter logic here. You simply used already developed counter. Already developed counter. This counter already developed is this one. What you have done? Simple two things you have done. Two things are you are playing with the parameter values. But playing with the parameter values, what you have done? You changed this entire code to 4-bit counter, and that is a down counter. That is a down counter. Because if you go here, that is this one, when down is 1, this is what exactly happening. Meaning what down counter. So that is here exactly, it's a 4-bit down counter. Did you write any code here? You did not write any code here. But magically, it is now, it has become 4-bit down counter. How it has become 4-bit down counter? Because of that power, the power of this usage, this parameter usage. That's why we call this is a parameterized module. This one is a parameterized. This one is a parameterized. So this one is a parameterized module. So now coming to this one here, this one.
During this instantiation, we have mentioned inputs, all the inputs, but why we didn't mention like output, right? What might be the reason?
During instantiation,
see, you can see like a counter U1 and then clock dot clock is there. All the inputs are there. There is no output.
That's good observation. So what do you think? What do you think now? What do you think? If we synthesize, this is the second assignment. Somebody asked yesterday assignments. So the assignments are now. What you have to do is very immediately after this session, what I do is I'll share this PPT with you people. You have to send me that WhatsApp group. You had to synthesize using that your Xilinx ISE. This is there, no? This one synthesis tool. This is going to work like. Satish, can you see this my screen?
Yes, sir.
So
the output will be depending on the input, no, sir.
Satish, hold on your doubt. I'm just going to give you the assignment.
Okay, sir.
And everything will be answered. Very good observation by Suresh.
Okay, sir.
So that observation is required with all participants. That's how we actually take active participation. So guys, here, the point that our brother Suresh made here is, I'm just making the here, if we have binded all inputs, but we did not bind the output. Why it is so? Is it like that? Is that okay? Or is there a problem? So for that, the answer is, you people have to work from home. What you have to do is, this one you have to do. This slide I will share with everybody. So what you have to do is, go to this one, particular this ninth slide. There you copy this one, this entire code. So copy this one, simply copy this one, and open this your Xilinx ISE software. You know how to open and how to create a project and how to open a file and everything you know. Already we have demonstrated this portion. There you simply paste here. So is that clear to everyone there? Can someone?
Yes, sir.
After that, what you have to do is simply save this one, and one more file you create, one more file in this same project, one more file. So let us say that is top. Give the name top, and then click next, and then finish. Okay. Now go to this slide again. This time the other one here, this one. So in this other one, let me take out this one here, this portion. Okay. This one you have to copy now. Copy this one. Okay. Are you able to see there, everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this one you have to copy. Now you come back to your Xilinx ISE. Remove this entire template being generated. Simply paste this one here. There. So after pasting this one, see everybody there, kindly notice you have V file separate, top, this file, both are separate now. Everybody Suresh, can you see this one? These are two seen like this separately.
Yes, yes, Jacket, yeah.
Now see the, what is that happening going to? See, this the moment I click on save all, see, how many do you see there, Suresh? Suresh?
Only one is there, yeah.
Only one is there. The reason why one is there, you see here, there's a plus sign. You had to click that and you see the other one. Why this happened? Because in this file design, let me zoom bit this one. F8. Okay, F8. Guys, there, you if you see, this is the top module, design top. Inside that, you are instantiating this one. That's why you, this one, you see the line, this is a, this counter is under this design underscore top. That's why earlier it was separately seen before saving. After saving, this file, the other file, counter is associated with design underscore top. Is that clear to everyone there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now that, now coming to the Suresh's question. So how we confirm this, whether this is correct or not? This is how you confirm. So you have to click this synthesize. Everybody, can you see there, Satish?
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
So double click this synthesize. Double click and wait. So this is happening. Let that happen. It will take a bit time. Okay, now you see everybody seeing their yellow. There is some mark here, exclamation mark here. I don't know how to zoom this one, but can you able to see there here this some there is unlike
okay. Able to see, sir. Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, yeah. So the point here is, if everything is fine, a green check mark will come, but this time some exclamation means some warning sort of thing. So these warnings, the tabs here, you see the tabs here, console, errors, warnings, find in files, these are the tabs. So if you click the warnings tab, you see the output is never assigned here. You see the output here. Everybody able to notice this?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So meaning what now, from this what we conclude is, one more point. Wait. You just expand this plus sign. Now go to your this RTL schematic or technology schematic. Double click this RTL schematic. Click the this one, the top module that you see. So if you double click inside, what is there? Not shown, but this is you know, as if these are connected to this design top. That's how we see. The impression that we get on having seen this RTL is clock, enable, reset N, and out are happily connected to design top. That's the impression that we are getting. Now let us click this view technology schematic. What is that going to happen in that? Let us try to explore. So this also, let me zoom to full view. Okay, zoom to full view. If you click this one double, if you double click inside, what is the logic that is not shown? Actually, it's supposed to be showing inside logic. So meaning what I'm trying to conclude with this is, you have, what you have done is, let me go to that slide, this particular slide. So here, this one. Okay. Now you have your, this one, input, clock, reset, and enable. So this is your CLK, and this is your reset, and this is your enable. All these are inputs here. This top module. And this top module also has got here out. And say one column zero. Now, but the inside, what you are doing here is connected to this module. This clock is connected to this one. This reset is connected to this one. This enable is connected. But the out here is not connected. This, there is a gap here. there is a gap, not connected here. So meaning what? It is not correct. That is the meaning. That is what the tool also warning us. The tool also warning us, saying that, where is that? Yes, warnings. You see earlier, oh, there's this warning. So design summary, here two warnings. Sometimes what happens is, if you don't locate anything here, go to this design summary report. Why? Because we have performed RTL schematic, view technology schematic. Sometimes you may miss them because the recently done things will be loaded here. So in that case, what you do, go to design summary report, and there you see nice reports here. There you locate warnings here. So there you click warnings. Now you see their output is never assigned. Are you getting everybody there? Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, Suresh, is that clear? All outputs of the instance of the block counter are unconnected in block design top. Suresh, is that answered?
Yes, Jakir. Yeah.
Yeah.
Correct.
So,
yeah.